an interesting conversation that my husband and I often have is him dating after I'm gone. So he'll be in his 40s, presumably. And I often think about that. And so initially when I was diagnosed stage four, I thought, how do people do that? How do people give their blessing to their spouse, especially for us, where we got married, you know, a week before, and I had been diagnosed 9 days before our wedding. How do people just say, yep, go date whoever you want? And then as time progressed, I realized this is about a man that I absolutely adore and have so much admiration and love for. Of course, I want him to be happy. And what's different is that a divorce versus death is that his love for me will never end. And so when he's potentially, I mean, he is convinced he'll never take his wedding ring off. He's never, you know, he is not interested in, he said, I don't want anybody else. I just want you. And of course, that's how I feel too. Cancer is making a different decision for us. But for him, when I have kind of said, I have given him my blessing 5,000 times over, because I know that, I mean, the poor woman who's going to potentially date him, the baggage she has to deal with, that's the tough thing, is that she has to now make space for my family and for my niece and nephew and for my parents. Like, what does that look like? I have no idea, and I'm glad I don't have to deal with it. But yeah, these are weird, strange conversations that I never thought, obviously, in a million years we'd be having. But I think by kind of talking about it and demystifying it a little more, it makes my husband feel a little more comfortable that if it comes down to it and he feels comfortable that, okay, maybe I will date again. Again, he's convinced he never will, but I hope he does, because the man that I love more than anything in the entire world deserves to be happy. But I know that's kind of complimentary to me as opposed to instead of me.